We're outside 770 here. This is a delegation from the court arriving for the Rebbe's citizenship proceedings. They're greeted by Rabbi Kazanovsky. The Friedrich Rebbe's Rebbetzin is serving refreshments. The Rebbe's son-in-law and successor, the Rebbe, joins him. Rabbi Kazanovsky. Sam Kramer.
That's Supreme Court Justice Leo Riefel, holding the register for the Rebbe to sign. You'll see Rabbi Charikov for a second on the top left.
This is the Rebbe's Yechidus Zimmer, his private study. In honor of the Rebbe, Congress passed a special law that citizenship could be granted in a private residence.
Look at the gentle way the Rebbe is assisting his father-in-law. Many of the students of the time speak about the Rebbe's tremendous respect, awe really, in his father-in-law's presence, Rabbis Sholem Goldschmidt and Yisrael Gordon.
It was something unusual, but the way the Rebbe was sitting, and this Rebbe, the Ramash, the time, the way he was sitting with a zah bittel, nish kein Wort ausgerät, like this in front of a Sefer Torah, that's the way he was sitting. In front of the Rebbe, all the time.
When he sat upstairs by the meal, he used to try to help his father. So the Rebbe used to, in case his spoon wasn't close enough, the Rebbe used to move over the spoon to the Rebbe. He felt the Rebbe wants a drink, he used to pour the drink. But it was done inconspicuously. A lot of respect, never a word spoken. He had this total bittle. The Rebbe, he's a chosid, he's in the respect, courtesy, subordination.
That's Yisrael Chanowitz. Judge Philip Kleinfeld. In between the two judges are two clerks of the court. Dr. Nissen Mendel of Merkez Linyoni Chinuch in the back there. The petition for naturalization.
With the brown hat is the famous Yiddish writer, Nissen Gordon, who wrote a beautiful account on this event in the prominent Yiddish newspaper, Der Tog.
The Rebbe treated this as a very special event. He's wearing his shtreimel, which is reserved only for special occasions. That's the signature card. The Rebbe is getting ready to take the oath of citizenship, and the Rebbe explains it to his father-in-law. Reb Zev, I understand that just 3 days later after this occurred, you had the merit to be in that room with the Friedrich Rebbe on the occasion of your upshadmish. The Friedrich Rebbe held out his tzitzis for you to kiss.
Yes, that's true.
The clerk, Mr. Antonelli, signs and hands the Rebbe the certificate, and the Rebbe thanks the contingent. The Rebbe says, Abraham, our patriarch, left Aram, which was a self-indulgent land. When he arrived in a place focused on compassion, producing, and sharing, he said, this is where I'd like to settle. Similarly, I found this country, a place of compassion, accommodation, and freedom. As an American citizen now, I'd like to thank the United States government, headed by the president, for its kindness and efforts in saving me from Hitler's hands. I give my blessing that the United States may have peace and success. Mr. Kramer asks the Rebbe to reenact some of the proceedings so that the photographers may get better pictures.
I think that for GEM today, which is preserving and producing videos of the Rebbe at such a high level, this film has a very special meaning. You know, the Rebbe himself arranged this event, and he did this recording of his Rebbe at the highest standard of that time. In 1949, it must have been a major feat to bring a film crew to 770 to record this high-quality color film. I think it's a lesson. The Rebbe was the first to do this. And he set a very high standard for how to value and treat these special moments.